In this step, we're going to make sure that our filter works in a 50 ohm system. The result of the previous step is that we scaled the characteristic impedance of the shunt stubs to make sure that they were between 30 and 80 ohms. In particular, Z02 was scaled to 80 ohms. A result of that scaling is that our source and load impedances were also scaled, but we want to use this in a 50 ohm system. And the solution is to introduce inverters. Yes, I know it seems as though we went to a lot of trouble to get rid of inverters, but now we have to introduce these inverters again. Now, these inverters could be as simple as quarter wavelength long lines with a characteristic impedance of 139 ohms, but there are other ways to do that. This is where our prototype stands now. We have capacitor values that are 2.7 picofarads. They're all the same here at this point in time. Now we're designing a filter at 1 gigahertz. A 2.7 picofarad surface mount capacitor is a very reasonable value. It'll perform very well. Our characteristic impedances for our shunt stubs are 67.7 ohms for the external stubs, for the ones on the outside. For the internal stub, it has a characteristic impedance of 80 ohm. So this will give us reasonable values for the width of the microstrip lines making up the resonator. This coupling characteristic impedance, well, that'll come about because of the separation of the microstrip lines. The further they are apart, the higher that value will be. So the residual problem we have now is what to do with that 139 ohm inverter. Now, 139 ohms is outside the range of allowable microstrip impedances, at least for the values that we'd like to work with.